Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, my husband wanted to pick this set that I did. So he chose a medium length square, milky or soft white set with some gold fringe tips. So to get this set started, I did already have my hand primed and prepped and the shapes already done. These tips that I'm using, I got on Amazon. They're the straight square tips and they're super, they're like a good thick. They're not thick to where it's hard to lay the acrylic on there, but they're thick enough to where they have like a good strength with them. I really like them a lot. And then I prepped and primed with the OPI Dehydrator Young Nails Primer. And now I'm going in with the Valentino Soft Touch White. This is such a super pretty white. I really like this white a lot. It's really, really elegant. Even when you just leave the color by itself. So I really like this white a lot. And then I'm using the Young Nails Craik brush as well as the Young Nails monomer. And I'm just going to build this acrylic out on the nails. And like I said, I'm keeping them all white and then just going in with the French tips. So this set was pretty quick and easy to do. And I'm using the Red Iguana 3.0 practice hand. I do really like this hand. If you want to see my full review, go down a couple videos on my channel and I have that full review on there. After using it for a couple of months, I do still really like it. The only thing I've noticed is it's kind of stiff when using it, but of course it's a practice hand, it's not a real hand. So typically when I'm laying acrylic, I like to pull that finger down, as you can see. So the acrylic pulls downward, and that helps with pulling around the cuticle area and going into the sidewalls and stuff like that. So it is a little bit harder to pull that finger down and keep it down, but I make it work. And then also when it comes to filing, again, it's kind of stiff. You can't move the hand around as easy. So I do feel a little bit of like crampiness in my wrists. Also, though, it could just be the way that I'm trying to control the hand. But other than that, it's been a pretty good hand so far.
Sorry for me, gonna just prove history. You say you're
Okay, so once I am done laying the acrylic, I'm going to go in with my hand file, and I'll separate the acrylic from the sidewalls because sometimes some acrylic will transfer over on there. So you just want to make sure you kind of go through and push your finger down on your client's skin just to make sure there isn't any thin layers of acrylic that transferred over. And then I'm going to start tightening in those sidewalls. And again, if you've watched my previous videos or in this video, as you can see, I am on one side of the finger on that sidewall. And I'm just kind of tucking that in right underneath to again, remove any of the acrylic that transferred into the bottom of that sidewall and nail. And then I'm going straight in with that sidewall. I will do that on all four sides of the one side of these sidewalls. And then I will go back through the opposite direction. This just helps me ensure that I'm keeping my wrist straight and I'm not going back and forth, back and forth. So it really does help save time. And it also helps keep straighter lines, so that way you're not twisting your wrist in all different directions going from side to side with each finger. If you go through and do all 10 fingers on one side and then all 10 fingers on the opposite side, it really does help keep that wrist straight and helps keep your line straighters. So I'll just go through and kind of tighten those sidewalls a little bit, pull them in, and get rid of any excess acrylic that may have transferred underneath. Okay, and once I am done tightening up those sidewalls and kind of bringing them in a little bit, I'm going to go in with my 5-in-1 Curasky bit. This is my absolute favorite bit for the cuticle area. I do just use it for the cuticle area because I think that it tightens it up and makes it look really nice. But as far as balancing and stuff, I don't really like to use this one because I do have another bit that I like to use for balancing. So this 5-in-1 Curasky I use just for that cuticle area, but I have seen this bit used for the full nail balancing, debulking, all of that. So it can be used for multiple uses. I personally just like to use it for that cuticle area. And then when I do come in with balancing, I'm going to go in with my safety bit. This is a medium barrel, medium grit. And again, like I said, it's a safety bit. And I really like this bit a lot for balancing. It does such a great job. This is the brand Creations, and I just got it at my local nail supply store, but I think you can get them online as well. And like I said, I just use this for balancing. I do kind of touch up around that cuticle area, around where that apex is at, and smooth it over and just make sure everything is smooth and finely going in, like coming together. And then I'll go through all the fingers with this bit here. Also, that Cura 5-in-1 bit, I usually have that set to an 8 when I'm working back behind the cuticle area. And then this bit, depending on the job size that I have, I start off with a 10, which I believe this one I was at a 10. If I have a bigger job or a lot more debulking to do, I will go higher on my e-file. But for this set, I just had it set to a 10. Okay, so after I am done balancing out that nail and I am satisfied with the cuticle area, I'm going to go in with my hand file. And I don't think I've ever mentioned, but I think I use the 100-100 hand files for acrylic. And then I'm just going to go back into those sidewalls and make sure they're still nice and straight and make sure those tips are even. Also, I'm going to turn my client's hand around and look at it from their point of view. This step is extremely important when we're doing our finish filing and shaping, just because it is from your client's point of view and it gives you a better idea of what they can see when they turn their hand around and look at it. Also, it helps you get a nice straighter edge and make sure your nails are all going the same length or the same way. They're all the same length and they all look in formity together. So it's very important not to skip that step. And then once I am done finish filing, I'm going to go in with my sanding band. The sanding bands that I am using, I got from Profiles Backstage. And if you haven't checked out their website, you should. They have lots of cute stuff on there, but I'm literally obsessed with the fact that these are purple. But then I'm just going to go over with that sanding band and kind of smooth out that nail, take care of any harsh imperfections in the nail with this sanding band. I know you're scared, you want to hide away sometimes. I know you're hurt. And then after I am done going over with the sanding band, I'm going to go in with my buffer. When you are buffing in the nail, you want to make sure that you are going up one direction and down the opposite direction or in a circular motion. Otherwise, you're just going to continue putting imperfections into that nail, and the purpose of buffing them is to help get rid of those imperfections. So you want to make sure you're either going in a circular motion or going up one direction, down the opposite direction. And then at this point, I would have my clients go wash their hands. Obviously, Nicole here cannot do that, so we are going to spray her with some alcohol and dust her off with our brush. And at this point, I am ready for design. So like I said, I'm going to be doing a gold French tip per my husband's request. So we are using the metallic stripers from Not Polish. And I'm just going to be using the brush that is in that bottle and drawing out those French tips. When I was painting the French tips on there, I did notice right there at the tip of the nail, the metallic kind of pools all together in like one little ball. So I did decide to cure in between each finger because I did notice that if I waited too long, the color would kind of pool together. So definitely, I really did like these colors and the stripers and everything, but definitely you do want to cure in between design, or maybe it was because I was using more amount than just like a striper amount. So I definitely would suggest curing in between, especially if you're using it for French tips or covering more area of the nail, just because, like I said, it did keep pooling together, but I thought they turned out super cute. So after I was done drying out those French tips on the nail, I went in with the Not Polish Gloss It and just put that top coat right over the top of this, and we were all set. I hope you guys enjoyed this simple, cute Frenchie set. This white is absolutely beautiful, and it turns out beautiful every single time. So I highly recommend it. If you guys like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're not already, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. And if you have any questions or comments or any concerns, just leave them down in the comment section and I will reach back out to you guys. And again, thank you so much for giving me your time of day and watching my video. I hope you guys enjoyed it.